Joining me now is Justin Holbrook to talk some Ohio football. So Justin, the spring game is coming up this weekend, so it's a good time to talk about what this team is going to look like this upcoming season. I know we've touched on this before, but will anybody challenge Darius Vick at the starting quarterback spot?
Well, Morgan, the answer is pretty simple. It's not really. Last year, Darius only had one challenger in J.D. Sprague, but in the chances he got, he never really proved himself. Sprague completed less than half the passes that he threw, and in the 10 games that he played, he only had 3 touchdown passes, and in the 4 games he started, Ohio never scored more than 20 points. So Darius definitely has to get better, but JD's not going to replace him.
So who is the biggest player that Ohio is losing to graduation this year?
Oh, it's by far Antoine Crutcher. For the last 3 years, he's been starting at the nose guard spot, and he's just kind of been an anchor for that defensive line. I mean, last year, Ohio held opponents to under 100 yards rushing 6 different times, which was leader in the MAC, and they also only allowed 25 points a game, which was 3rd best in the conference. So without Antoine, I see them kind of struggling, but I think they can right the ship early in the season.
So what about Chase Cochran? Who do you see kind of replacing him as the deep threat receiver?
Well, it's definitely hard to replace a receiver like Chase. I mean, last year he had 21 catches, which was down from 37. And I think Ohio kind of misused him last year because, I mean, the year before he was kind of used everywhere, but he was only a deep threat last year. So I think Ohio needs to go away from that, but his replacement will definitely be Sebastian Smith. Last year, Sebastian had 31 catches for the team and was 2nd most in receiving yards. So I see him replacing Chase as the go-to receiver for Darius.
What about some of the returners? Can you talk about them a little bit?
Some of the returners, I think the biggest returners is not just one player, it's the entire offensive line. Ohio returns all of their starters from the offensive line. And last year, Ohio had 7 linemen that are coming back that played in at least 8 games last year. So that's definitely going to help Darius, who kind of struggled last year. And also A.J. Ouellette, who is probably the biggest returner from last year going into the season. Nobody even knew who A.J. was. He was a walk-on freshman, didn't even get any playing time really in the beginning of the season. But then he just kind of stepped up. He played in 10 games for Ohio and averaged almost 5 yards rushing. So he's probably the biggest returner that the Cats have.
So what does Ohio need to work on the most this year to have a season above 500 and make a bowl game?
Well, starting with defense, the biggest thing they need to do is improve their pass defense. Last year, they ranked 10th in the MAC in pass yards given up, which was just terrible. I mean, they had a great run defense. We talked about that in Antoine Crutcher, but their pass defense has got to get better. But on the offensive side of the ball, it has to be Darius Vick throwing it. Because we talked about their struggles last year. Last year in the MAC, they ranked 10th in passing yards. And I mean, when you have a team that's not really passing and running the ball more, it's easy to predict what they're going to do heading into that game. So they need to work on their passing tech more than anything. And the last thing they need to work on is turnover margin. Last year, Ohio ended the season in -4 in turnover margin, which is kind of a reflection on that 6-6 year. They didn't even force a fumble until halfway through the season, and their interceptions were down too. So if they can up the turnovers, they can definitely up their records and maybe even finish with an 8-4 record and go back to a bowl game for Frank Solich.
Well, do you think there are any players from the incoming class that will start at the beginning of the season?
Well, starting with the defensive side of the ball, I see one player that really stands out, and his name is Deontay Williams, and he plays safety. He comes in as a 4-star recruit from ESPN, and I don't just see him playing, I see him starting a majority of the games that when he comes to Ohio. And he's not only a big impact player, but he can also raise that defensive ability because the Cats kind of finished low on the end of the totem pole last year when it came to pass defense. But on the offensive side of the ball, I see Elijah Ball coming in and helping Sebastian Smith a lot because Elijah has a ton of speed and he can also help Darius in late game situations.
Well, we'll find out in the fall if some of your predictions are right. Thanks a lot, Justin.